Dear Yogi Virendra Yogi, I belong to India and I stay in city of Hyderabad of Telangana state in this Yogi Nivas of Nani city, and always my heart is filled with joy, love, serenity and calmness because I am a yogi. Yogi means a man who is dedicated, committed and who loves birds, fish, animals and plants, and who believes in the philosophy of truth, justice, peace, love and non-violence, and never allow his mind to be polluted by the evil thoughts, that is greed, anger, hatred, jealousy and cynical thoughts. But in India, you see, people are very different. They are power-mongering people. They all want to really misuse democracy and come to power. Why they want to come to power? Buddha renounced all the power. He was a prince, Gautama Siddhartha. But he renounced his kingdom and he really loved mankind. He wanted to enter into the world of peace, tranquility and joy for everyone. That is my creed. That is my philosophy of life. Don't be power-mongering. If you really love mankind, try to acquire wisdom, wealth, education, innovation, everything, so that the wonderful world will be a better place for everyone, not only for mankind, but for birds, beasts, animals, plants. That's me. We don't want any power. That is the real power of a man. To behave like a man. To be rational. To have love. To have affection. To have kindness. To eliminate all the evils from the society. That is humanity. Not power. Recently, you see, the India, the power game is going on. Bal Thackeray was a man from Maharashtra. He has deep-rooted hatred for some kind of religious community and he has started Shiva Sena. But he is misusing Shivaji Maharaj. He was a patriotic great Indian. He was fighting against a great demon, Aurangzeb, who was a plunderer, who belonged to the dynasty of Babur. Babur came to India, invaded, conquered, plundered, massacred, converted temples into mosques, ruled for 100 years and more. He came in 1526 and the downfall came when the British eliminated this Mughal dynasty. Beloved friends, now the evil generation of Bal Thackeray, his son Udham Thackeray, he is compromising all the philosophy of his father. He wants power. He has become the chief minister of Maharashtra. He has made alliances with the people against whom Bal Thackeray fought all his life. I ask you the question, why they want to come to the power? Why power? They are greedy people. They are selfish people. They don't have love for the citizens of India. They want power. They want power for self. They want power for their dynasty. Nehru, whatever he is, he fought for freedom of Mother India. India got freedom. He was selfish. He really tried to eliminate Subhas Chandra Bose. So I have always placed for Subhas Chandra Bose as a great patriotic Indian. But Nehru dynasty, you see, is ruling India. Now it is degenerate because the wisdom, the greatness is not a patriotic property. It is not paternity or maternity. It is acquired. It is learned. Rahul the idiot, the greatest fool born on earth. His sister Priyanka, another great idiot lady. She only chants Nehru dynasty. What is their sacrifice? What their wisdom? What is their contribution? All these polluted people want to come in power. They make false promises, but never they fulfill those promises. Their only goal is come to power, enjoy the power vested in the chair. For that matter, Narendra Modi also. He may be a saintly man, he may be a patriotic man, but as he is the Prime Minister, he is enjoying the power and position far, far superior to the monarchs and kings and emperors. Thousands of security guards, the best plane, the best everything. The goal of these political leaders should be to serve the motherland. Whether power they enjoy or not, but the motive should be the servicing, the suffering humanity, the citizens of India. India is still a poor country, a developing country. There are a lot more things to be done. Beyond everything, what should be done? Because this is the land of Buddha and Vivekananda, people should not become murderer. People should not become killer. People should not dwell in impure thoughts, greed, anger, hatred, jealousy and cynical thoughts. Read the paper. Watch the news. Every day people are abusing each other, killing, massacring. Great. Great. The most powerful people are in jails. Chidambaram, Home Minister and Finance Minister, he is in jail for corruption. Lallu Yadav, who ruined Bihar on the caste politics, he is in jail. His son instantly picked up some matter. Tell BJP, tell Nitish Kumar, who was Godse. Bloody Godse was your father. Godse was worse than your father. He has certain principle. He has certain ideology for Mother India. His mind was polluted, criminal mind, who killed a man with different ideology, Gandhi, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. But your father killed the sentiments and the expectations and hopes of the millions of the people of Bihar. Dear friends, Yogi Virendra Yogi, India needs Yogi Virendra Yogi, that is Buddha and Vivekananda. Serve your motherland. Serve the people of India with the spirit of Subhash Bose, with the spirit of Bhagat Singh Chandrasekhar Azad. Then you are Indian. Only then you are Indian. Power mongering, Uddhav Thackeray, shameless. Where your ideologies have gone? You wanted power. And you have become a dynasty ruler. Sonia Gandhi, inheriting Congress, want her dynasty to plough. Lallu Yadav dynasty. All dynasty. All dynasty. Shameless. Where is patriotism? Where is love for the Mother India? Love needs sacrifice. Gandhi was symbol of sacrifice, no doubt about it. He may be doing lot of wrong, child abuse and all, where his creed. Because he was human. His mind can be negative and positive. Nobody is permanently great. It is an ideological thing to have always a positive mental attitude. But definitely he was striving and seeking different ways and means to retain the great virtues and quality of truth and justice. I warn you, Indians and citizens of India should arise awake and see that these political corrupt people, when they come in power, they need to do justice to their mandate. They have made promises to the people of India. No luxury for them. The constitution should be amended. They have to live like common people. They have to live like Gandhi lived, in the lion clothes, representing 20 crores Indians at that time. That's the spirit of Yogi Virendra Yogi. Whether I live or not, Mother India should live with dignity, honor and pride. The children of Mother India should learn from Gandhi's sacrifice, the sacrifices made by the wisest of the wise, Buddha and Vivekananda. I appreciate and invite 1.35 billion people of India. Forget caste, creed, race, religion. Unite for a noble cause. To love everyone, to care for everyone, to use the resources of the motherland to make everyone's lives happy. Truth, justice, peace, love and non-violence should be the creed of Mother India. That is the land of peace. Everyone has said Buddha. We give Buddha to the world means peace, joy, happiness. Idiots, you are going to die anytime. Nobody knows when anybody will die. But you are living to kill others, to plunder others, To rob others, to murder others. Shameless. Go to jungle. Go to jungle. Become beast. Lions, tigers, hyenas. Shameless. Black spot on humanity. Learn from the sacrifices made by Socrates, Abraham Lincoln, John F. Kennedy, all the martyrs, Martin Luther King, Gandhi, Chandrasekhar Azad, Subhash Chandra Bose, Bhagat Singh, Lal Bal Pal, collector, collector, power mongers, shame on you, no principle, power, power for self-patient. I feel ashamed that the world is suffering because of the greedy hyenas and wolves. The viewers, spread the message. I want a world, joy, peace, happiness for everyone. Thank you.